Oliver is a domestic short hair cat. Cats are made up of three parts: a head, a body, and a tail. Together, they make the length of a cat. Oliver the cat has a 30 centimeter long tail that he's very proud of. He has a small, round head with sensitive, clever whiskers. Oliver's head and body together are 1.5 times as long as his tail. His head is equal to twice his whole length divided by 15. How long is Oliver the cat? How long is his head? How long is his body? When you see a word problem like this, it may feel like you don't have enough information, but you do. It helps if you write out what you know and what you don't know. Along the way, you have to kind of translate from sentences into the math language of algebra. You'll identify unknowns, give them a variable name, like x, and then solve for x. The more you do this kind of translation, the more second nature it will be. It really is like speaking a different language, or a dialect anyway. Here's what we know. The length of Oliver's tail equals 30 centimeters. We don't know his entire length, head plus body plus tail. We don't know the length of his head, or the length of his body. But we have some sentences that tell us relationships between the length of the tail and these other parts of Oliver. There are 3 sentences that give us clues about how these lengths are all related to each other. We can convert the sentences into equations. 3 equations, 3 unknowns, so we do have enough information to solve for everything. Head plus body plus tail equals Oliver's whole length. I'm going to use x, y, and z for the 3 unknowns. Head is x, body is y, and whole length is z. You can call them anything you like, but that's what I'm going with. Substituting in what we know so far, x plus y plus 30 centimeters equals z. Our next sentence tells us that Oliver's head and body together are 1.5 times as long as his tail. Let's write that in math language. X plus y equals 1.5 times 30 centimeters. X plus y equals 45 centimeters. The next sentence, giving us a relationship between the lengths, says his head is equal to twice his whole length divided by 15. In math language, we'll write that as x equals 2z divided by 15. Now, let's start putting some of these pieces of information together. We know that x plus y equals 45 centimeters. In other words, Oliver's head plus body together equals 45 centimeters. We can add that to the tail to get the whole length. 45 centimeters plus 30 centimeters equals z, the whole length of Oliver. Oliver is 75 centimeters long. Now let's use the next expression, x equals 2z divided by 15. X equals 2 times 75 divided by 15. X equals 150 divided by 15 equals 10 centimeters. So now we know the head and the tail, and all that's left is the body. 10 centimeters plus y plus 30 centimeters equals 75. Or the body equals 75 minus 30 minus 10 equals 35 centimeters. We also could have used our earlier equation, x plus y equals 45 centimeters. Remember that stood for head plus body equals 45 centimeters. 10 centimeters plus y equals 45 centimeters. Y equals 45 minus 10 equals 35 centimeters. To summarize, Oliver's head is 10 centimeters. His body is 35 centimeters. His tail is 30 centimeters. He adds up to 75 centimeters in length. Good job, Oliver. Enroll for free to Socratica High.